Now, cells, structure and function is the next topic. You must have read about cells. You have already learned that things around us are either living or non-living. So the substances which are non-living, you know they are made up of. Do you know? They are made up of atoms. Similarly, living organisms are made up of cells. So here we read about what is a cell, and what is the structure of a cell, and what is the function done by a cell. So different sets of organs in our body, they perform various functions. You have read that there are various organs in our body, but in a cell, which is the smallest structural part of a living body, the cell has got the function which does the function of all the parts of the body. Cells may be they can be compared to bricks. Many bricks are used to make a wall. Similarly, many cells join together to make an organ or a living body. So when was the cell discovered? How did we know that cell is actually there? Robert Hooke discovered the cell. He discovered it under a microscope. At that time there was no proper microscope, but the microscope which was invented at that time was made up of simple glass. And during the manufacture of glass, one of the deformed glass behaved like a lens. So he used that lens to observe the cell. So Robert Hooke studied it, and he found that every cell. What did he study? He studied a cork. Cork is a piece of wood which you must have seen under a shuttlecock. It has got small holes in it. So he studied that cork under a microscope, and he found that inside a cork there are small compartments or hole like structures. So these hole like structures reminded him of cells. Cell at that time was the name, and today also it is used to define a small jail. You must have heard that prisoners are kept in small jail, which is called a cell. So from that time, cell is the name given to the compartment. So he called that the holes inside the cork looked like a cell, so he called it a cell. These were boxes or compartments in the cork. He also noticed that one box was separated from the other box by a wall, and there was partition. There were many boxes and they were separated by a partition. Robert Hooke coined the term and he called it a cell then. Cells of living organisms could be observed only after the discovery of improved microscope. At that time when the discovery of cell was done, there was no powerful microscope. Later on, when the strong microscopes were made, then the detailed structure of microscope was studied. Then very little was known at that time, so slowly with the discovery of better microscopes, the cells were studied. Now the cell, both bricks in a building and a cell in the living organism are the structural unit. When you make a wall, you need bricks. So each brick joins with another brick to make a wall. Similarly, many cells join together to make a living body or make a organ. The buildings, though built of similar bricks, have different designs, shapes, but when they all join together, they make a wall. Similarly, many cells, when they join, cells in a living organisms, when they join together, they do one work. Cells in the living organisms are complex living structures, unlike non-living. Now here in the figure, there are two pictures shown. One is a brick wall in which you can see many bricks joined together, and the second shows an onion peel which is seen under a microscope. It has got many cells which are joined together and then they make a orange peel. So the cells are compared to an egg also. The egg of a hen represents a single cell, and it is big enough to be seen by a naked eye. So cells are microscopic structures which can be seen with the help of a microscope. These cells perform the function of a living body. The egg of a hen is also compared to a cell because the egg of the hen contains a living structure which later on divides and grows into a chicken. Now the next topic is organisms show variety in cell number, shape and size. It means that the living organisms have different types of cells, they have different type of shape of the cells, and their size of the cells are also different. How do scientists observe and study the living cells? They use microscopes which regularly study the objects. When they are studied in a microscope, then we know about the shape of a cell. There are millions of living organisms. They have different shapes and size. All living organisms have different shapes and different size. These organisms, because they have different shape, so they have different type of cells. There are different types of cells in the organs also. There are number of cells. Now they have asked a question, can you guess the number of cells in a tall tree? The number of times, the number of cells which are present in a tree will be in millions. How many cells do you think are present in a living body? There are millions of cells. We will not say uncountable, that they are countable cells, but there is a fixed number for them. The number runs into billions and trillions. Human body has trillions of cells which are different in shape. They are all different. Why are they different? Because all of the cells are doing different function. Organisms made up of more than one cell are called multicellular. You have read about it, that what are multicellular and what are called unicellular. The organisms which have more than one cell, they are called multicellular organisms. The number of cells being less in smaller organisms does not mean that the functioning of the organism is different. In a multicellular organism, there are many cells which are doing different functions. You will be surprised to know that the organisms with millions of cells begin their life as a single cell. Even if you're like, if there is a bigger organism like you only, or there is a bigger elephant, in the beginning when it was born, it started its life with a single cell. So every multicellular organism in the beginning starts its life from a single cell, which is later on, which is actually a fertilized cell. We will read it in another chapter. The fertilized cell later on multiplies, more and more cells join to it, and then it becomes a multicellular organism. There are two pictures shown at the bottom. The first picture is of amoeba and the second picture is of paramecium. Both are single cell organisms and they are unicellular. They are called microscopic because they are not visible with our naked eye. They can only be seen under a microscope. What is the shape of the amoeba? The first picture, it has got no fixed shape, but paramecium looks like a shape of a slipper. So it means that unicellular organisms have different shapes. They have not got the same shape, but they have different shape. And then they are microscopic, unicellular. They do all the function